What is up, y'all? It is your boy, Weed Peeler, in my house. Welcome to the garden vlog you guys have been asking for, and it looks good, man. I'm glad I waited about a week. It rained for about 4 days straight. Everything is nice and green and flowers everywhere. It looks so good. And look, we got nature in motion over here, man. We got a little butterfly pollinating a lily. Check it out, dude. What is up, man? Perfect time for the vlog. Oh, you look good, bro. That's sick. Sick. I love you. Good job. All right, so let's work our way into the good stuff. Maybe I'll go over everything with you just real quickly. You know, I've done this before, but we got a fuchsia hanging up over there underneath the awning. Hates the heat, so in about 2 weeks I'm gonna have to water that thing every day. But it's got some cool looking bell flowers on it. It's actually really neat looking. I like that, and we've done it for about 2 or 3 years straight, and yeah, it looks good. So we got a nepeta over there, purple flowers, it's gonna bloom pretty soon. And then again in late fall, we got some glads in the middle, spiky flowers. These things are gonna get nice and tall, about 4 feet tall, and then they're gonna get nice spiky flowers. They look cool. And my babies, the lilies, look at these. These bloomed this morning for you guys. They knew I was gonna make a video. Those are awesome, man. Those are all gonna be yellows right there. And then we got white ones over here. They look sick. Some snapdragons, looking good. They're all budded up, ready to pop. We got some yellows, we got some reds. Creeping phlox, it's actually done and over with. Finito. We got the Vedra flower. Sup, baby, how you doing? And yeah, this is the mainstay of the garden right here. Beautiful looking stuff. We got some phlox over here that's done. We got some lilies that are about to pop off. Some roses, you know, some oriental lilies, these real tall ones here. These are awesome. Look at this Jack and the Beanstalk looking thing, man. Boom. It's got a freaking tree trunk on it. Look at it. So yeah, each of these buds gets to be about probably 4 or 5 inches, and then they open up into like a ruffled white smelly flower. They're so awesome, man. I can't wait. Then we got some lilies here. These are different looking. Not my favorite, but my girl likes them. My mama liked them, so I picked them up. They look pretty cool, but they're not like a standard lily. They look like teacups almost. So they're neat. I like them. Add a little bit of difference to the garden, and I like the orange color too. Million bells, super bells, whatever you want to call them. They are absolutely fantastic. They love the sun, as you can see. I'm gonna deadhead some of these. Once you knock off the dead stuff, the good stuff comes back and it looks happy. It looks like it's trying to reach the sun. Weeps, show me the sun. This is the Dark Knight, the Batman rose. Haha, it's actually bloomed a couple days ago and dried up. Looks kind of crappy, but that will continue to bloom throughout the summer. Got a bud right there. Can't wait for that. That's actually one of my favorite looking flowers. I do like that a lot. We got some more lilies over here. We got some red ones. We got some yellow ones, I believe. This rose was actually knocked all the way down to the bottom. There was nothing left after the winter. And it came back. We got 3 buds on it. Can't wait for that to show up. Some more super bells. We got the purple ones this time around. Those are pretty, pretty. And then these boys, the stargazers. Oh man, that's sick. That's a big old bush. Getting ready to go. But each one of these bad boys, again, is gonna be like 4 or 5 inches. You guys saw these last year. The stargazers are absolutely stunning. One of the best looking flowers I think I've ever seen. They're just absolutely gorgeous. They smell so good. You can pull into the driveway and they just, you can smell when you get out of the car. It's unbelievable. And then bam, look at that thing. Look at that thing, the cherry parfait. Dude, that's sick. That is one of the coolest looking flowers too, man. That is a beauty. Beauty. Look at this cluster right here, man. You can't even find this in a florist, bro. That is what Weeps does on his day is off. That's beautiful though. That is absolutely gorgeous. We got some more oriental lilies here, and then this rose, probably my favorite of the garden. It actually smells really, really good. It's humongo. It's bigger than my hand. So getting ready for that to pop off some more. It's got some buds on top. It's gonna look really, really good. But this thing, man, this thing took off. It looks absolutely fantastic. We got some more oriental lilies over here. The muscadets, buds everywhere, man. It looks so good. Over the moon, this thing actually bloomed last time for you guys last year. This one, it's a little late this year, but it's got some big buds on it. It's gonna be absolutely gorgeous. That's a really, really fragrant rose too. It's kind of like a peach, looking good, ready for that. This bush, I know I've told you 18 million times, but this is an actual clipping I took of my grandmother's mother's bush. It's like 100 years old or whatnot. I just actually clipped a piece and was able to propagate that bad boy. And look at all the buds on this thing, man. It's ready to pop off. Boom. Got all these, all those. It's awesome. So that's an English rose right there. That is cool. So I'm definitely super psyched about that. Blooms around Father's Day, and then again late fall. So definitely looking forward to seeing some more of that. This is a new rose bush, looking a lot better than it did when I first planted it. Definitely shot a lot of new growth. All of this reddish stuff is all new. That should beat up and bud up pretty soon. Got some more glads and some lilies that already bloomed and done in ova. And then the phlox, man, that is monster. That's the peppermint phlox you guys saw from last year. And I think there's some regular pink one in there too. Definitely cool looking bush, but that thing's like tripled in size. It's humongous. Look at that bad boy. And then these things, what wicked cool lilies those are. That is super, super, super beautiful. Look at that. Try and get right in. Beautiful. Absolutely beautiful. So I'm glad that this is going to be in bloom for my mama's birthday tomorrow. Should be fun. Hydrangea looks hit, but the problem is you can't chop all those sticks back because then it doesn't flower, which is ridiculous. But yeah, it is what it is. Butterfly bush has seen better days. That's finally really kind of perking up. I chopped it way back. It was doing pretty bad. Had a lot of winter damage, and hopefully it continues to grow up nice and tall, attracts butterflies, hence the name the butterfly bush. And we got the golden showers. That sounds funny. The golden showers rose bush. That's a creeping rose. Should go up the trellis and then contrast nicely with the clematis. So nice purple clematis, nice yellow rose. Check out this rose. This is beautiful. You can probably smell it through the camera, man. That is absolutely beautiful. We got some pansies, some snapdragons. We got gladiolus, everything mixed in. Clematis back there, looking pretty good. This, unfortunately, I love it, man. My Japanese maple is beautiful, but you can see cuts in the middle. It had winter damage too, and I had to chop off the main stem. It was so tall. It was doing so good. This is the year it really filled out, and now I had to chop it back, and it looks retarded. So, unfortunately, it doesn't look as good as it could, but still very happy that it's still alive and didn't die, because it could have died, and then I would have been devastated. So, cool looking. And then we got some balloon flowers here. These spread like a crazy person. They were actually growing up nice and tall, and then the rain came, beat them down, and now they're growing like curved up. So that should be cool. They get little flowers that look like balloons, and then they pop and they have a flower. So yeah, looking good. And yeah, some more lilies over here. I did build my girl a fence for her her vegetables and stuff. We got blueberries too. Check it out. The blueberries, nice. We actually got some this year. We can actually eat some. Then we got some mint. Mojito time. Ah, nice. So this is the fence I built out of PVC pipe. Pretty neat actually. Picks up from one end so that she can get in there and do her thing. You know what I'm saying? That's right. Weeps knows how to build stuff. So yeah, it's a chicken wire fence. It's gonna be pretty cool. We got some tomatoes in the back over there. We got some peppers over here, and we did some cucumbers. Maybe some beans, I don't know, maybe these are all cucumbers. But yeah, pretty cool looking stuff. So definitely excited. Here is the backyard. I need to do some work. We're having a party tomorrow, and I need to definitely sort it out. Yeah. All right, so thank you guys for watching. Hopefully you guys enjoy this, and many more flowers to come. Peace.